What's great about manga is not just how insanely vast and diverse it is in the stories they tell and the art styles they have, but also because it's one of the most personal storytelling mediums. Unlike anime, where there's a huge team working behind a show, there's an intimate, unabridged connection between us and the mangaka. The vision of a mangaka and what they want to tell through their stories is conveyed with a certain distinct individual flavor to them. Among this vast sea of talented mangakas, there are a certain few artists that give off such individualities in their works that you could tell from a glance by reading a page or two that it was made by them. Kaoru Mori is one such mangaka. What makes her works immediately stand out for people who aren't that familiar with them is its noticeably iconic art style. The art is consistently gorgeous for almost every single page, and the detail in them is absolutely outstanding, especially when it comes to clothing designs and immersive historical background art. Kaoru Mori-sensei is most notably known for her works focused on maids in Victorian Britain called Shirley and Emma, and more recently for her magnum opus Otoyomegatari, a historical romance manga set in Central Asia. She started her career making self-published works, or otherwise known as doujinshis, when she was in high school, where she caught the eye of a recruiter at a manga publisher who offered her publication in their magazine. This was how Emma was born. Emma is a 10-volume completed manga about a housemaid in 1985 Britain who falls in love with a person in the upper class, and it's about the challenges that they have to face in order to get together. A year later, while Emma was still publishing, she started making another manga about maids in a similar setting. Yet rather than a historical romance, this time it was a more slow-paced and wholesome manga about a 12-year-old orphan girl finding a new home as a maid and living with her kind-hearted mistress. While reading these two manga, it was evident to me that even from an early stage in her career, she was focused on her stories being as historically driven and accurate as possible. Her passion for England was very noticeable, and the attention to detail given to even the smallest things in her manga regarding the setting and time period were outstanding. She's even gone as far as visiting England in order to gain more material for her manga. But we saw her full potential and artistic skill bloom when she started her magnum opus Otoyomegatari in 2008, a manga that revolves around different brides in Central Asia and their very specific problems surrounding their fiancés or husbands. Otoyomegatari is simply put one of the best looking manga of all time. The manga is picturesque in all of the right ways, the background art is immersive and immaculate, she plays around with her paneling in the most creative of ways, and the way she occasionally uses white spaces instead of detailed backgrounds is the perfect cherry on top for the entire visual experience. Her manga also features very languid pacing, and it's filled with beautifully crafted scenes having no dialogues and captured with just body language and paneling. Kaoru Mori-sensei's character designs are extremely striking as well. While they're not super detailed like Takehiko Inoue's Vagabond or Shichi Sakamoto's Innocent, they have a certain nuance and intense realism to them that makes them different from mainstream character designs in manga. The characters somehow look like real people who lived in that era, and it's partly because of the costume designs, yes. But there is something amazing about the way Kaoru Mori draws women. The way she draws naked women in particular is something very unique and beautiful when compared to a lot of her other contemporaries. It's not exactly fan service, but she more so shows off the feminine beauty and elegance of women. And I think that's genuinely great and something I wanna see other mangakas do more often. And talking about women in her stories, the diversity and representation of women in her manga are always amazing. She presents some very strong female characters who lived in a society where women didn't have a lot of rights, or during a time where women being independent past a certain age was frowned upon. It shows women in an empowering light in a way that's very realistic, just like everything else about her manga. In her own words, when asked by an interviewer about this, she says, despite what kind of culture people live in, it's usually the mother who's the head of the family, whether it's in Central Asia or not. In general, that's the role that has the most power inside a family unit. So did I actually try to present some particularly powerful female characters? I don't think so, at least not on purpose. I don't exactly seek to make strong female characters. I just want them to seem interesting to the reader, regardless of their gender. I think that's another strong forte of hers. She creates very empowering characters of different nationalities or genders in a very natural way. A great example of this would be how she showcased an Indian prince as the main love interest rival of the protagonist in Emma. He was charismatic and straight up hot in an Indian kind of way. As another hot Indian guy myself, I was extremely pleased with this representation. I briefly mentioned it before, but Kaworu Morrison's historical world building and attention to detail is outstanding and makes her manga very immersive. She makes use of the time periods her manga are set in to dive into more questionable subject matters such as age gap romances or couples with multiple spouses. Her characters are all interesting and different from one another, and their character arcs are all brilliant. While all of her works are fairly character driven in nature, equal emphasis is given to making the setting and time period as alive as possible, which I think is a great duality of the author. She wants to transport us and make us travel through all the different locations in her manga. Kaworu Mori feels like a mangaka that pushes the idea of manga as an art form rather than as a piece of entertainment. But the best part about it is that it's not intentional on her part. She simply wants to create good manga and in the process create such interesting, unique stories that will go down as modern classics. If you don't know which of her works to start off with, I usually recommend Otoyo Megatari, as you can't go wrong with it. It's undoubtedly her best work and it has a lot of different elements in them for everyone to enjoy and appreciate. If you're a fan of slow-paced soul-cleansing manga like Yokohama or Natsume Yujincho, then I'd suggest Shirley, as it's the manga without many dramatic elements to it and it's mostly a wholesome story about a young orphan maid and her mistress. If you want a more cinematic romance with a lot of conflicts and a relatable female protagonist, then Emma is the one for you. Emma embraces a lot of the tropes you see in romance stories, while being its own historical piece with Mori-sensei's touch to it. I think Kaworu Mori-sensei has made more than enough manga in her career to be known as an all-time great, but she is still relatively young and in her early 40s. I cannot wait to read more of Otoyo Megatari while it comes out monthly, and I hope she makes more manga in a different setting and time period once Otoyo Megatari ends. Her consistently outstanding artwork, her unique and gorgeous character designs, her obsession for historical nuance and world building, her focus on women empowerment and on the lives of ordinary people in historical settings make her a unique and special mangaka, and I'm honored to have her as the first of many mangaka that I want to highlight on this video series of mine. Mangaka Spotlight is a video series that I'm really excited about making, where I want to talk about different mangakas and highlight their works, some of which might be fairly underappreciated or unknown among mainstream anime and manga communities. If you guys have any mangakas that you want me to talk about on this video series, just tell me on the comment section down below and I'll most likely make a video talking about them. Don't forget to like this video if you've enjoyed it, and please do subscribe to this channel if you haven't already. It helps my young channel a lot and I want to keep on doing this. Thank you guys for watching this video. Sayonara, and I'll see you guys next time.